It's Keri from Salesflare, and today I'm going to help you with importing. I'll go over how it works, what the golden rules of importing are, and what to do if something goes wrong. First, head to Settings, Import Data. Here you can import any CSV file. Just drag and drop your file, depending on what tab you want to import, or use the plus sign down here at the bottom of the page. If your data is in Excel, just use Save As to save as CSV, which stands for comma separated values. Import all entities separately. What I mean by entities are the accounts, contacts, and opportunities. Again, you can drag and drop your file under the specific tab or use the plus sign down at the bottom. If you plan to import more than one entity, make sure to always import accounts first. This is important as it will allow you to link the contacts and opportunities to the accounts later. Any data you want imported must be matched to an option in the drop-down menu. If you leave one drop-down menu blank, then that column of data won't be imported. You can find the list of standard field options for import in Settings Customized Fields under Account, Contact, or Opportunity. Pro tip, if you name your headers exactly as you see them here, then you won't have to select anything from the drop-down menus when you import because it'll automatically do it itself. Can't find what you're looking to import in the drop-down menu? Create a custom field for it before you import. You can also do this in Settings, Customize Fields. Click on the right entity at the top, and then the plus sign down at the bottom. For example, I want to create a custom field on opportunities for notes. So I go to Settings, Customize Fields, click on the Opportunity tab, and then the plus sign down here to create the custom field. Now, once I create this custom field, it'll be available in the drop-down menu for when I want to import opportunities with notes in them. So first, like I mentioned earlier, import accounts first. That's because the way Salesflare works is accounts are central and contacts and opportunities are linked to them. That means that the accounts must first exist in Salesflare before you can import anything linked to those accounts. So let's say you have a file of leads you want to import. In order to import the opportunity, Salesforce has to know at which account you have these sales opportunities with. That's why you must make sure the account exists first in Salesforce before you import something linked to it. Similar situation for contacts. If you don't specify which account the contacts belong to, then the contacts will only be imported into the My Contacts list. For example, I want to import a contact of mine named Peter, who works at PayPal. If I don't include that he works at PayPal in my CSV file, the import will simply place him in the My Contacts list. But if I do specify which account he belongs to, then when I import his contact will automatically be linked to the PayPal account, and our email, interactions, etc. will be pulled in. There are some requirements when importing each entity. I'll go over which fields are required per type of import, and I'll also mention what fields are highly suggested to import as well. So for accounts, it's required to import a name, but it's also highly suggested to import a website. Why a website? That's how Salesforce pulls in information about the company automatically for you. For contacts, required is name or email, but it's highly suggested to import both. That's because names are good to have in general, especially when using the merge tags in the email campaigns. And the email is how Salesforce pulls in email conversations, calendar meetings, and enriches contact information automatically as well. For opportunities, it's required to import account name. That's because you have to know which account the opportunity is linked to. And it's highly suggested to import the pipeline and stage names as well. If you only have one pipeline and want to import opportunities into the first stage of that pipeline, then you don't have to worry. Salesflare automatically imports opportunities into the first stage of the first pipeline. If you have multiple pipelines and/or want to import opportunities into specific stages other than the first one, then make sure to have this data available for import. Remember, import is for creation, not for updates. The exception to that rule currently is contacts, as creating a contact with the same email address updates the contact. If your file has duplicate accounts or opportunities in them, make sure to remove them before importing. If you import accounts and/or opportunities with the same name, they will duplicate and show a 1 or 2 or 3 next to the name, depending on how many times the account or opportunity has duplicated. If this happens, not a huge deal. Just make sure to delete the duplicates before you import again so that you don't have any more numbers next to the name. You can do this by clicking on the account avatar, selecting the ones you want to delete, and press the trash can at the top. Be aware of the type of fields that you're importing so that you don't map the wrong type of data to certain fields. You can check which type of data is required in Settings, Customize Fields on the right-hand column for each entity. So for example, size is a number field. That means that only numerical data will be accepted, like the number of employees, not text as if it's small, mid-size, or large. Like right here, Microsoft has 100,000 employees. You should include the number of employees, not that they're a large company. The rest of these will fail upon import unless you change it to an actual number. If you're importing dates, they must be in year, month, day format, where year is 4 numbers and month and day are each 2 numbers, all with dashes in between. To change the format in your file, select the dates, press Custom, and then select the correct format. Did part of your import fail, or did it fail completely? You can find out what exactly went wrong by downloading the fixed import file. For example, I have a failed import here. This fraction here means that 8 out of 8 records were processed, but 7 out of those 8 failed. The one that didn't have any errors is already imported, so I just needed to download the fixed import file, edit the 7 failed ones, and re-import to have the remaining records import successfully. Error messages appear here on the right in a new inserted column called Error. For example, this error says the account does not exist. That means the accounts I've listed in these rows aren't actually accounts in Salesforce yet. Therefore, I can't import a contact linked to that account since it doesn't exist. This message most commonly happens when accounts weren't imported first. But don't worry, that's an easy fix. Just take your list of accounts, import them under the Accounts tab, then you can go back to your fixed import file, delete the error column, and re-import under the Contacts tab. If you got a different kind of error and you can't figure out what it means, I've put in a how-to article in the bio of this YouTube video that explains the different types of import errors you can get and what their translations are. Okay, that's all I have for you today on importing. If you have any more questions, you can always reach me down here in the chat. Thanks for watching.